Okey, baik. Assalamualaikum dan juga selamat malam diucapkan kepada semua penonton-penonton, khususnya yang menantikan segmen yang diminati ramai, iaitu segmen Inilah Ceritaku, di mana satu segmen yang berkongsikan pengalaman sebagai pedagang mata wang asing. Ya, tuan-tuan dan puan-puan, ramai di luar sana yang perlukan, yang dahagakan tip, ya, pengalaman bagaimana permulaan, pertengahan, suka, duka, pahit, manis, ya, bergelar seorang trader. Baik, untuk episod yang ke-126 untuk malam ini, kita akan bersama dengan Muhammad Hafiz dan telah pun berada di hadapan saya, Muhammad Hafiz. Sihat Hafiz?
Alhamdulillah Pak Su.
Sihat eh?
Okey.
Okey, baik, alhamdulillah. Sempat makan sate ke tak?
Oh, sempat. Sempat 2 batang lah, cukup lah.
Eh, tak cukup tu.
Balik kan.
Habis ni nanti kita akan sambung. Okay. Baik, yang dah ada dekat wall kami sekarang ini, Nick Saleh, Steady Coach. Kita ada Yusri Zainul, saya hadir. Assalamualaikum Pak Su dan tetamu terbaik Yusri. Kemudian kita ada Niza Minza Zainul, terbaik coach. Zakwan Zainal pun dia bagi tanda bagus. Kemudian Sky GTR, Coach Hafiz from Jaguh Academy. Wah, ini dah popular dah ni cikgu ni. Okey, bis. Lebih senang untuk perbualan. Apa kita, apa Su nak panggil? Biasanya orang panggil apa?
Biasa student panggil Coach Hafiz. Hafiz sudah memadai lah. Okay, Pak Su lebih tua, just call me Hafiz cukup.
Cantik. Kau ni anggap aku macam tua sangat, Pak. Okey, baik tuan-tuan dan puan-puan. Kalau ada persoalan tentang apa saja yang akan kita sembangkan, contoh macam bagaimana start belajar, apa yang perlu ada, tip, itu semua anda boleh letak kat ruangan komen. Lepas tu insyaAllah Lepas tu akan cuba tanyakan kepada Hafiz, Coach Hafiz, untuk dia perjelaskan. Okey. Muhammad Amir Irfan, salam coach. Abang Pen pun ada Wah, sekarang dah popular Abang Pen kita. Abang Pen video beli telefon terbaik. Baik, kita mulakan dengan sedikit biodata. Nama, asal daripada mana, kerja ke atau apa ke? Sedikitlah latar belakang untuk pendengar-pendengar, penonton-penonton di luar mengenali Hafiz.
Okay, terima kasih Pak Su. Okay, first of all, thank you kepada CTCFM kerana sudi berjemput saya.
Baik.
Saya juga datang juga atas capacity on behalf of Jaguh Forex For You. Sebelum ni kami dikenali sebagai Jaguh Forex For You. Now Jaguh Academy, Jaguh Technical Analysis. So
Jaguh
we are more known as Jaguh Forex lah. Yeah. Okay, so
asal
nama saya Muhammad Hafiz Badul Rahman. Asal saya lahir di Muar, and then membesar di Johor, tapi mostly di Shah Alam, and then Putrajaya, and now saya reside di Cyberjaya lah, dekat saja kat sini.
Oh, dekat je, tak adalah jauh sangat. Maknanya memang di Cyber ni cari makan ataupun dah memang mau statin atau macam mana?
Memang ada rumah sendiri di sini dengan family.
Okey, baik. biasanya segmen ni diorang ni akan suka bila dengar cerita pengalaman kan. Sebab diorang nakkan pengalaman tu sebagai sempadan diorang berjaya. So, okey, permulaan Hafiz mengenali dunia dagangan mata wang ataupun forex.
Okey, boleh. Kalau tak silap saya kenal trading ni bukan asalnya melalui forex market, bukan.
Okey. Bukan, okay.
Bukan. Forex ni last kali setelah saya melalui instrumen-instrumen yang lain.
Wow.
Baru saya terjebak kepada forex
Okey.
So kalau ikutkan cerita dia, first of all I started with options trading.
Okey.
So How did I get involved with option trading? Biasalah. I mean, umur saya tahun ni 32.
32
32.
Oh, macam 17 tahun.
Terima kasih. So,
okay. SPM, itu tahun berapa ni?
I SPM 2005. Okay, then I belajar dekat Nottingham University di Semenyih.
Baik.
So, waktu tu 2007-2008. So, maybe I was about 17, early 20, 19 macam tu. Waktu itu kan biasalah kita student. So kalau student waktu tu kalau duit poket tu taklah banyak sangat kan. So kita,
itu je masalah student itu je
satu. Poket lah kan. So my father gave me about maybe 50 ringgit per week. So then you survive lah. I mean, you duduk dekat waktu tu universiti swasta. So dia punya dia punya cost of living tinggi sikit kan. So I was thinking
sangat mahal.
So I was thinking maybe I should do something to supplement I punya perbelanjaan everything. So kalau Pak Su ingat time tu, kalau 2007-2008 tu, kalau kita buka newspaper macam The Star, NST dekat bahagian especially on business section tu, kan waktu tu agak popular on how to make money online, how to make money through stock market.
Sangat banyak
everything kan. So because waktu tu saya terfikir, I mean before I start trading, I dah daripada bermacam-macam cara untuk how to make money. So I was like, biasa tu time tu popular with property. Yeah. Time tu budak 19 tahun nak beli property macam mana kan?
Betul.
And then satu lagi options was like jual beli online kan. Waktu tu popular was eBay waktu tu. Then waktu tu
apa yang ada masa tu? eBay lah
paling popular kan. So waktu tu was like bila kita masuk eBay, we have to have a product and everything. Kan? So I don't have a product waktu itu. Then waktu itu dropship pun tak berapa popular. And then satu lagi cara nak make money is through trading share market waktu itu.
Okay.
So then waktu itu kalau dekat newspaper tu banyak seminar saham, especially how to get involved in US stock market. Waktu tu US stock market is very popular.
Sangat.
And then I consult my father lah kan, sebab my father dia belajar di US dahulu. So dalam dia punya syllabus tu ada berkaitan dengan options trading. So when I talk to my dad, is options trading sih boleh buat duit ke tak? I mean, can I get involved with it kan? So my dad told
me. Maknanya minta persetujuan daripada ayah dahulu.
Because nak join seminar tu, saham tu kan beribu-ribu.
Memang so, beribu ringgit.
So it's not going to come up with my money. I don't have that money. So okay, I need to ask for my father punya blessing lah kan. So my dad said, okay Hafiz, why don't you go for it? You pun belajar finance accounting management. So
kebetulan. Belajar pun kos. Okay.
So ada sedikit berkaitan lah kan.
Betul.
So then I try. So I still remember waktu tu my first course, I think kalau Pak Su perasan time tu pun popular, my first seminar conducted by Kishore M waktu tu, Power Up Capital. Sampai ada dia pada Singapore.
Kishore, okay.
Okay, so the cost was 5,000 waktu tu. Biasalah waktu tu you buy course
Singapore ke ataupun Malaysia duit
dia, dia daripada ringgit Malaysia.
Okay,
so
baik.
Dia daripada so dia daripada Singaporean, then dia datang KL. Okay. Dia almost ada conduct seminar like every month lah macam tu.
Baik.
So I first attended dia punya kelas. Okay, biasalah kelas 2 hari Sabtu Ahad, and then dia ada buat live
untuk
trading
RM5,000
tu
2 hari.
So lepas tu dia ada buat live trading session pada hari Isnin malam tu lah, just to because Isnin US market kan buka Isnin malam Isnin. Kan.
Maknanya Sabtu Ahad tu dia bagi
coaching teori and everything.
Lepas tu hari Isnin malam tu dia akan live trade
lah, dia tunjuk lah how dia live lah kan, how nak set up account pada. So from there I because waktu itu pun training provider tu pun dia ada bermacam-macam courses. So I first started with options trading. Lepas tu dia ada perkenalkan futures trading and everything lah. So with that one guru
dia banyak pecahan kat situ.
Dia ada pecahan lah. So with him I belajar options, I belajar CFD, I belajar futures trading waktu itu.
Futures, eh? Yeah, okay.
So to be honest with him alone, I think I spend roughly at least about 15,000 ringgit untuk just for the cost itself only. Right? So
banyak.
Then you know lah, lepas habis course, my first course tu.
Okay.
Then biasalah kita start trading demo just to get familiar with the platform and everything. Then you need other capital pula untuk get involved with the stock market kan. Then waktu tu you to get involved with US stock market, mungkin paling kurang you need to have about between $2,000 to $5,000 as a initial capital to get just to get started lah kan. So then I ask my dad again.
Okay.
So I was like, I mean I'm very fortunate to have a father yang support sangat-sangat in this trading journey lah kan. So he gave me about I think about $4,000 to $5,000 to start off. Waktu tu tak macam sekarang.
Maknanya kan? Dah lepas pada 3 sesi tu yang habis sampai 15,000 tu, ayah bagi lagi untuk start.
Yeah.
Untuk yang real.
Yeah, yang real account.
First time.
Yeah. Because my dad told me, Hafiz, I'm not going to all these courses.
Okay.
I'm old enough untuk sit in the in the seminar for the whole 2 days.
Betul lah.
So he was asking, Hafiz, you belajar betul-betul. Alright, and then you teach me how to trade. And then lepas tu kita trade sama-sama lah kan.
Baik.
Okay. So I was like, okay. And then I funded my account $5,000. And then waktu tu murah lagi Pak Su. It's like exchange rate is like macam 3.1, 3.2. That was in 2008. Tak macam
2008 masa tu kan.
Ya, tak macam sekarang 4.2, 4.3, 4.4 kadang-kadang kan. Okay, so then I still remember. I mean, biasa saya cerita kepada saya punya student jago ataupun orang yang pergi ke preview seminar kelas jago kan. Selalu orang cakap ada beginner's luck kan.
Yeah.
Okay. So it happened to me. Because waktu tu my first trade, I still remember, I was buying call options untuk Yahoo punya share.
Yahoo eh?
Yahoo. Yeah. So the main reason why I bought,
dia popular mestilah orang cari dia kan.
I buy Yahoo punya share tu pun because kan ada CNBC.com and whatever it is kan. I nampak headline waktu tu Yahoo dia plan untuk buang 5,000 pekerja. So waktu tu when I first started options trading tu, waktu tu di 2008, waktu tengah at the peak of financial crisis.
Okay.
So market waktu tu baru nak turun kan, daripada 2008 sampai ke 2009. So then as a business student waktu tu, kita punya simple logic, kalau sesuatu company itu dia buang pekerja 5,000 pekerja, then basically buang pekerja, you cut cost, then you increase you punya profit margin, then then better profit, and then good for your share, then hopefully the Yahoo punya share akan naik lah kan. So that's why I buy call options with expectation for the Yahoo to go up. Then I buy daripada $5,000 tu, mungkin I allocate about $2,000 waktu tu untuk buy Yahoo punya share saja.
Okay.
Then waktu saya di hostel, yalah biasa kalau prep malam semua orang discuss untuk belajar. Study, belajar
untuk
kan,
kelas esok,
untuk kelas esok kan. So while I was studying with my friend, yalah waktu tu 2008 lah, waktu tu 4G pun tak ada lagi kan. No. Internet is not widely available waktu itu kan. So we just go to the cafeteria. So then I tiap-tiap malam I tengok lah what happened to the share. And then I sometimes you busy belajar ni kan, you terlupa ada position Yahoo.
Betul.
Until one time when I studying with my friend, keluar satu flash news dekat CNBC.com tu waktu itu, it was saying that Microsoft, company Bill Gates tu, komputer Microsoft tu, dia bid to buy Yahoo. So maksudnya Microsoft dia cuba nak membeli Yahoo waktu itu.
Okay.
So I was thinking, I think I have a Yahoo punya share kan. So I was wondering what is happening to my,
baru teringat.
Oh, teringat lah tu kan. Busy with the courses and then the assignments, presentation, whatever tu, waktu tu lah kan. So I was like, I better check my account kan. So berlari lah pergi to other part of my campus for a better connection, because very bad connection waktu itu. Then I was like, I check. Then I was terkejut. I was almost want to like Yahoo, nak you buy Yahoo share, you want a Yahoo kuat-kuat kan,
nak melepaskan rasa gembira,
rasa gembira tu kan? Because we don't actually know the effect waktu tu, tak macam dulu kita boleh tengok chart dekat phone macam sekarang kan. You have to like login and everything.
Dulu so memang terhad sikit,
terhad sikit lah kan. So I terkejut, was like daripada 2000 seed investment tu, you buy, I tak allocate semua my 5000 tu, just 2000 saja untuk buy Yahoo punya share. Imagine that $2,000 tu, dia punya capital gain ni about $6,000. I untung $6,000 waktu itu. That will be about kerja tak sampai 2 minggu waktu itu. Options pun ada expiration every month kan. So imagine for a person umur 19-20 tahun, when you like
dapat
have
duit macam tu kan,
$6,000, time tu kali 3,
18,000.
So I was like, wow kan. So okay, then
sangka tak masa tu? Sebab tu first kan,
the first trade. Tak sangka lah. So then I thought maybe my approach was correct lah kan.
Sebab betul lah kan, jangkaan, sebab baca fundamental
lah kan. Sebab waktu tu, waktu saya pergi dia punya seminar tu, dia ada lebih kepada technical and fundamental. Tapi waktu saya join dia punya seminar tu, my first technical analysis punya approach adalah ada chart, chart ni ke atas tu. Lepas tu bawah dia ada MACD, ada stochastic, RSI, ada macam-macam kat situ lah kan, my first involvement kan. So I rasa benda tu macam pening sangat. Then I just look, waktu tu I just tengok news sajalah waktu itu kan. And then
juga kat situ ya.
It just happened that nak tengok semua buat apa kan. Then I was like, okay, I close my position 6,000. And then after that I trade again. And then I lost that $6,000. And then after that, then baru okay, this is maybe the beginners lah kan. So then I start trading again options waktu tu. Then that was the only time yang I think I rasa untung satu position tu banyak, 6,000. Then after that I still trading because I still have my seed capital.
Okay.
And then maybe jadi dah agak phobia sikit kan. So I was like, maybe pun tu 500 kali masuk 1,000 kan, $1,000 satu transaction. The account was growing.
Maknanya walaupun dia depo tu tak hilang, tapi dia punya grow tu agak
very slow lah.
Tapi itu dikira bagi Pak Sul lah ya. Walaupun tak dapat macam yang 6,000 tu, tapi still jana income betul.
Yes. And then from that, lepas tu bila financial crisis tu, then I pun, yelah kita trade my 2008, first experience 2008-2009 waktu US subprime crisis. So waktu tu memang it's a very tough market lah. Market keep going down. I still remember one time waktu US government tengah announce all those kind of bailout punya news. Time tu, if Pak Su imagine share bank macam Citibank, Goldman Sachs, it's very dirt cheap. Contoh, I still remember I bought options untuk share Citibank. I still remember waktu itu it's about harga dia dalam 20 sen 30 sen US dollar.
Masa tu
waktu tengah financial crisis, I mean almost all bank almost less than $1 US dollar. Now it's in hundreds, $200 kan. So I still remember I buy some Citibank punya share dekat I punya campus in Semenyih. Then somehow waktu itu internet was down. The last time I check, I think I untung dalam buat $2,000-$3,000 waktu tu.
Okay.
Then I was about to close and then dia punya internet down pula dekat universiti. Then I have to drive go back to my parents' home dekat lah Putrajaya kan, but still about 30-45 minutes.
Yelah, lama juga tu.
Yelah, because market was at 9:30. Then when I come back at home, maybe sampai rumah pukul 11, pukul 12. Then when I take back, untung $2,000-$3,000, now it's like tinggal $100-$200. Just, that's it.
Kalau then, masa tu, internet okay rasanya.
Maybe I will have a better trading experience lah.
Itu yang mahal dia.
Itu yang mahal.
Nanti kita akan tanya perbezaan antara stock dan juga
forex nanti.
Okay, forex.
Boleh.
Baik. Bila masa pula terjebak dengan
forex tu?
Dengan mata wang asing pula.
Yeah. So when I bila dalam keadaan financial crisis tu, so my account was not really doing well waktu tu. I mean I don't really have that apa, not really satisfied lah with my performance. And then then my mentor waktu tu that dia buka lagi course. Then I start to trade futures.
Okay.
Then I start futures. I'm not really interested with futures. And then waktu tu 2009-2010 baru forex tu meletup.
Yeah, betul.
If you remember lah kan, waktu tu forex trading meletup. Then waktu tu pun kita pun sering dimomokkan dengan forex ni, you can start as low with $100, $50. Betul. And then you can grow your money secepat yang mungkin kan, setinggi yang boleh kan. Then I was like, okay, maybe I can try.
Boleh cubalah ni.
Boleh cubalah kan. Then I pergi. And then it was good. Waktu tu, I mean, yelah kita tengok market naik, jumpa resistance ke apa ke, kita sell. You know, I mean, in forex market, you can make money up and down, those kind of stuff. And
depan belakang boleh.
Depan belakang pun boleh kan. So it's like, okay, I try. But then it still wasn't up to my expectation. Ada untung, ada rugi and what not kan. So until I almost give up in trading. Because you know lah, I mean I mean apa, I was at the crossroad lah juga waktu itu kan. I mean, should I like focus on trading or should I just, you know, look for a job 9 to 5 macam tu kan.
Okay.
Then until one of my old course mate dekat seminar-seminar trading yang saya pergi ni, then dia suggest, Hafiz, why don't you go to this class conducted by Jago Forex waktu itu, arwah Cikgu Kamal Kasiman waktu itu.
Okay.
Then macam saya sebelum ni, I mean, saya tak pernah pergi kelas yang conducted in Malaysia waktu tu.
Okay.
Because after I join the class from Kishore tu, then I spend other courses on some trader daripada UK and then another trader daripada Canada. Okay. And then still about $5,000. Waktu tu kalau course seminar 2 hari dan 3 hari lah, Sabtu, Ahad, masuk hari
Senin, biasanya sampai ke 5,000.
Standard tu 5,000, 5,000, 6,000, 7,000 macam tu lah. Then bila my friend introduce this class jago ni,
okay,
by Cikgu Kamal ni, apa dia bayar dalam
550
ringgit waktu okay. tu. Dia maksud biar betul sebelum ni pergi kelas
mahal-mahal
ya, ini Cikgu Melayu 500 je. I was a bit skeptic lah waktu
confident
tu
kan.
Sebab kita dah terbiasa dengan kelas yang mahal kan waktu tu. Then I was like, okay, I give it a try. I told myself this will be my last class lah, hopefully. Then from this I will decide. And when I join kelas Cikgu Kamal tu, because the thing that really make me interested, I join dia punya kelas because my friend told me that Cikgu Kamal ni dia punya background was like ex-banker, the okay. ex-floor trader and everything kan. So I was like, okay, I want to give a try. Then when I first join kelas Cikgu Kamal tu, that was in 2011 I would say.
Oh, okay.
Jago diasaskan 2010. Oh. But I join in the middle batch lah,
okay.
bukan among first 50 student dia, tidak. So then I join dia punya kelas. Then bila I join dia punya kelas tu, it really open up. Inilah benda yang saya cari selama ini. Yeah, because I mean, kalau ikutkan perjalanan trading saya tu, if people ask me, Hafiz, who are your mentor ataupun people yang influence in you punya trading, okay, I would say the first one yang paling banyak big influence is arwah Cikgu Kamal Kasiman, pengasas Cikgu Forex.
Okay.
Lepas tu the second one was Chris Lorry.
So Chris Lorry.
Nah, Chris Lorry ni, and then satu lagi Auntie Mona. Yeah. So little bit background of them. Macam Chris Lorry ni, dia ada conduct course lah waktu tu.
Okay.
So dia punya background, dia Olympian. Dia Canadian.
Okay.
Dia Olympian. So dia involved in sports, apa tu, bobsleigh, winter sport kan, winter sport yang
okay, salji, okay.
Salji yang meluncur, salji and everything tu. Dia naik yang bobsleigh, yang apa, yang dalam macam boat yang dia meluncur laju tu, yang tiga orang, orang single tu kan. So he was a sportsman, and not just ordinary sportsman. He's a Olympian, gold medalist, world champion.
Betul ke?
Betul. Apa tu, boleh Google Chris Lorry. .com.
Chris Lorry, ya?
C-H-R-I-S lepas tu L-O-R-I, macam tu lah. So yelah, kalau macam sportsman, dia punya hayat, punya career not that long kan. Maybe by 30 dah retire habis. Kan so lepas dia retire daripada daripada mana, daripada as a sportsman, dia dah retire daripada dia punya kerja as a sportsman. So dia get involved with trading and then he become a fund manager waktu itu. So from him, dia banyak apa, banyak instill in terms of support, resistance, price action lah.
Okay.
Dia banyak bagi base yang kuat dekat situ. Alright. And then the second one was Auntie Mona. So Auntie Mona ni, she's a bit special. I like to tell the story of Auntie Mona to my students because it become an apa, dia menjadi satu inspirasi kepada kaum
cara
wanita.
Cara dia mengajar ke ataupun background dia ke,
dia,
atau
dia cara dia buat duit tu, ataupun because biasa kan kalau Pak Su pergi seminar mana-mana course forex ke whatever it is, maybe daripada 10 lelaki tu mungkin 2 ataupun 3
betul,
perempuan
betul.
Kan
nak
so
say, yang kaum hawa ni susahnya.
So her success stories, I always tell my especially students yang perempuan, it can be a inspiring story. Because when I first join, she's my course mate. Kita orang pergi course Kishore ni lah dulu ni kan, dulu.
Okay.
So dia, when I met her, she was 40 years old macam tu. Mid 40s or 45, aku tak remember. So anak dia 7 ke 8, ramai anak dia. She was a full time housewife. So she was like, yelah nak supplement income kan. So dia pergi course, macam saya juga, course 2 hari. And then what I like about her, I mean, dia beritahu saya lepas dia habis course 2 hari tu, she apa, dia hanya treat EURUSD. So for the first 1 week tu, dia try demo trading lah. So he was telling me, Hafiz, you know what, my first 1 week tu I tak tidur. Nak tak tidur lah, maksudnya dia almost monitor pergerakan EURUSD tu. Somehow dia boleh get connection with EURUSD, and then dia boleh faham character inside and out. Sama jugalah macam kita kan, kalau dah kenal isteri kita tu 5, 6, 10 tahun, kita tahulah PL dia macam mana, perangai dia macam mana dia kan, okay. Bila, so dia tahulah EURUSD punya perangai ni macam mana kan. So after 1 week tu, she funded $1,000 in forex trading. And then guess what, in 3 months, by only trading EURUSD satu pair saja, she grew from $1,000 kepada $100,000 dalam masa 3 bulan. Yeah, for a woman, anak 7, housewife. So waktu tu, that was in 2010-2009. So she was telling me that, Hafiz, once I, my account dah bust, dah apa, dah grow to this kind of amount of money. So she was saying that ramailah broker call dia, standard lah tu kan. So until one time tu, she got offer pergi ke Hong Kong waktu tu, become a fund manager. And then from Hong Kong, dia kerja fund dekat UK. And then the last I heard from her, dia kerja dekat US. So so then kita waktu tu, it was like tanya dia macam mana lah dia trade ni kan.
Okay, yalah, so dalam masa 3 bulan kot,
3 bulan tu kan. So then I told her, because dia dah pergi overseas kan, managing fund. So I asked her, whenever auntie in KL, you just buzz me, then I want to meet auntie. And then auntie ajar lah kan. So I always met her dekat, because bila dia turun dekat KL, from KLIA tu dia naik KL Central, pergi from KLIA dia pergi KL Central, ada hotel apa tu, Hilton dekat situ. So kita selalu lepak dekat situ, dan dia ajar lah how they trade and everything kan.
Tapi
saya tak faham.
Tak faham lagi masa tu.
Tak faham. Okay. Sebab one thing yang Pak Su perasan lah kan, I think saya pun perasan, I mean, tak semestinya trader yang berjaya, yang fantastic, yang betul-betul buat duit, can become a very good teacher.
Betul.
Tak semestinya juga, a very good teacher, if you ask him properly, whether he's really making money in trading kan. So then waktu itu WhatsApp tak ada, Telegram tak ada kan.
Memang.
So when she was overseas, sometimes I, dia ajar saya through chatting dekat apa tu, Gmail punya
Gmail,
chat,
okay.
Gmail punya chat tu kan. So whenever she's online, pukul 12, pukul 1 pagi tu kan, kat sana dekat UK and US is like siang,
siang
kan
lah.
So I was like, whenever dia online, I just buzz nanti, okay, what are your position kan. So every time that dia bagi tahu dia tengah buy something, sell something, after that mesti untung punya. So her signal was like really fantastic, because she is in,
adakah dia terus menggunakan, dia terus dengan pair kegemaran dia tu?
Tak, dia dah start
banyak pair
lah in fund management kan.
Okay.
So the last time that I heard from her, she was managing about, I think US dollar 400 not US dollar, apa, 400 juta British pound waktu tu. She was managing some Arab punya
oil money
lah, fund daripada sana kan. So and then then I lost contact somehow with her, because last time I heard from her that mungkin inilah, dia dah at certain age, at certain stage when she's really at certain level, dia mungkin nak kurang expose diri dia. I'm not sure waktu itu.
Dia memang macam tu.
Memang macam tu kan. So
dia bila permulaan dia study, lepas tu dia trade, lepas tu dia berjaya trade, dia dah berjaya, dia dah sampai pergi, dia akan duduk dan diam.
Dia diam kan. So lost contact with her. Then I was like hilang cikgu lah waktu
hilang
tu kan.
Hilang punca lah sikit.
Hilang punca kan. So when I met Cikgu Kamal in Jago Forex waktu itu, baru terbuka mata saya, what, apa yang Aunty Mona was trying to explain to me yang saya tak berapa faham sangat tu, Cikgu Kamal explain. Maksudnya trading, apa, cara trading, apa yang Aunty Mona buat and Cikgu Kamal buat, apa yang dia ajar di Jago, are the same. So then I thought, okay, this can be my last class, which is true enough, sampai sekarang Jago is the only class last yang I pergilah.
Berapa so, tahun tu yeah, Hafiz abdikan diri dekat Jaguar tu?
I think in 2011 sampai sekarang dah 2020. Tapi kalau I belajar dengan Cikgu Kamal directly, mungkin daripada 2011 full time, 11, 12 sampai 2013. Even bila saya belajar dengan directly with walaupun saya belajar di Jaguar pun, it's not a fast result, tidak.
Betul.
It still takes me maybe about 1 year to really understood apa yang dicuba sampaikan. And then you know lah kan, Cikgu Kamal wasn't my first cikgu kan. Sebelum tu saya ada beberapa cikgu lagi. So dalam banyak benda-benda karat dalam kita punya nak buang yang lama tu susah kan.
Susah, memang
nak
susah.
Masuk body yang baru
kita masih nak masukkan yang idea kita tu kan.
Yes. So to get his apa method, then it took time for me lah.
Okay, kenangan pahit.
I still remember mana satu yang saya ingat lah. Kalau student-student saya, dia selalu, cikgu boleh tak analisa gol kan? Saya beritahu student saya boleh analisa gol tapi saya tak trick gol. Because I have a bad experience in gol. Ada waktu tu kan, lepas join Jaguar lah kan. So I just, waktu tu popular trading gold kan. So I was like, okay. Then I buka satu account, Trend US dollar. Then that account dedicated untuk just trade gold.
Okay.
Based on apa yang Cikgu Kamal ajar waktu tu. Daripada $300, in 3 months, I grew into $5,000.
Oh, cantik.
Just trade gold saja. Then after that, daripada $5,000 tu, I just burn everything. Lepas 1-2 minggu. Because MM dah tak betul sikit kan. Ingat kan, dah boleh terus kan, you know, biasalah macam tu kan. So from that I abandon gold. Okay. And my experience juga, I pernah lost in 2013. There was one time I lost about I think about between $20,000 to $25,000 in trading oil waktu itu.
Banyak
dulu. Sebab waktu itu itulah saya kata-kata tangan nak trade oil. Macam if people ask me, Hafiz, what is your best performance in trading? I grew about $2,000 kepada almost $90,000-$95,000 dalam masa 6 bulan waktu itu in 2013.
6 bulan ni.
So daripada 95,000 tu dah hujung-hujung tu, I trade gold lah kan, I trade oil waktu tu. Sebab kita tengok oil price waktu tu at $120.
Okay.
Now is today is $30 per barrel kan.
So kali ganda dah.
So I nampak 120 tu resistance and everything. So kita bantai lah trade oil kan waktu tu kan, sell lah kan. So kita trade forex biasanya tak kisahlah if you hold you punya position 1 bulan, 1 minggu, 2 minggu, tak kisah kan, dia tak ada expiration. Saya pula terlupa bila kita trade oil tu dia ada expiration punya contract kan.
Betul lah.
Then I ambil contract yang agak singkat, which is I beli, let's say I beli this week, dia akan expire dalam masa 2 minggu. So macam saya punya trading style lebih kepada relax trading style. Okay. I mean not scalping, I mean much more paling low saya tengok time frame pun H4, H1. So swing trader lah. In our mind 120 tu is really the resistance kan. And then the naik sikit, lepas 110 naik 111, 115, naik 120 kan. Then then nak tak nak I tengah rugi $25,000 waktu itu. Then I was dah tak boleh buat apa, kena close. Then I close, I realize. And then sebulan lepas tu daripada $120 dia go down sampai 80, 70, 60. So I was like, If I realize that the expiration punya lot. Yelah, kita sebelum tu kita trade forex.
Betul,
kan? Kita terlupa oil tu dia ada expiration dia. Kita tahu dia expiration tapi just terlupa. Just excited tengok, oh ni kat resistance dia kan, ni boleh sell, ni ada weekly pun dah cantik. Long term ni memang boleh turun. Sebab kita pun dah terbiasa hold position 2 minggu, 3 minggu kan. Itulah kalau saya beli maybe 2-3 bulan punya expiration, maybe much better lah. Nah tu bad experience lah. So now if I trade oil pun maybe and it's really smaller lot lah.
Trade juga kadang-kadang.
Trade juga oil kadang-kadang.
Okay, ada tak pepe yang menjadi kegemaran?
Kebanyakannya is yen pair, macam pound yen, euro yen, GUEU. Lately, for the last 2-3 years, apa pair macam GBP OZ, GBP NZD. I don't really have a specific favorite pair because any pair yang matching kita punya analisa, I just go for it biasanya.
Maknanya tak ada tak ada tumpu dekat satu-satu pair macam GU-GU je, tak adalah eh.
I used to have that set. Contohlah because waktu 2013 tu, to be frank, lepas sudah main, if I just go a bit
okay, boleh,
keluar
boleh,
sikit
boleh,
nah,
boleh,
sebab
boleh.
Topik sebab dia berkaitan. So I join Jaguar late 2010, okay. Early 2011, aku don't remember exactly. So for the first one year tu, I tak trade sangat, langsung I tak trade. I just devote myself on buang yang mana tak patut, and it's still benda yang baru for the first
setahun
one year.
Tu?
Setahun tu? Not really setahun lah, for the first 6 months.
Yelah, betul lah. Kita nak buang yang lama tu, nak masuk yang baru, tak nak bercampur.
Yes, so mungkin waktu for the first 3 months tu, bila saya terpesona dengan kelas jago waktu tu, kita ingat dah pergi kelas 2 hari tu dah cukup lah kan? Sebab the way that jago operate, is that you pergi kelas asas dia setiap weekend, and then it's being supported by weekly webinar. Waktu tu kalau mana-mana student jago yang lama, dia tahulah Cikgu Kamal ni kalau buat kelas 2 minggu sekali, hari Isnin dan Khamis atau Jumaat lah macam tu.
Isnin dan juga Khamis.
Khamis Jumaat tu. So
setiap minggu tak pernah miss.
Tak pernah miss. Waktu tu ialah daripada pakai Skype and then pergi kepada webinar. Masa tu lah kan. So because waktu tu Cikgu Kamal bagi tahu ya, jangan berhentikan pembelajaran you di kelas asas ni saja. Sebab the juice of it datang daripada kelas revision tu. Sebab dia daripada kelas revision ni dia akan ajar how to apply all the tools in market condition pada waktu itu. Sebab lepas saya join kelas Cikgu Kamal ni, then barulah saya beritahu ayah saya, "Daddy, I can confirm assure you that this is the class that you can go." Sebab sebelum tu dia tanya Hafiz, "When can I go to seminar punya course?"
Okay,
kan?
Pasal ayah tadi kan, bila Hafiz nak pergi ke kelas jago, adakah ayah tahu ataupun jago-jago pergi pergi dulu?
Dia tahu, dia tahu. Saya beritahu, "Cik, Daddy, I want to go this jago kan."
Okay.
So saya like, "Okay, you dah pergi kelas berapa banyak kan? How much that I've spent nak pergi kelas lagi buat apa kan? I think you have enough." That's it. "Telah, I think I need another one." So dia pergi, then because dia juga nak juga pergi kelas kan, dia minta saya recommendation kan, "Should I go to this class and what not kan?" Olah, that class 5,000 mahal buat apa kan,
then yang ni baru 300
je, 550, and then I think daddy, this is really a good one. Then dia pergi kelas, I and my father pergi kelas sama waktu tu.
Okay.
Then
anak bapak sama naik tu.
Okay. So lepas tu waktu tu saya duduk rumah bujang dengan my friend, okay. Sama yang berkaitan bangsa waktu tu. So my dad, dia lepas dia pergi kelas yang 2 hari tu, dia join Cikgu Kamal punya webinar punya session tu setiap minggu tu, yang dua hari sekali tu kan. Saya tak join, saya ingat 2 hari tu dah cukup lah kan, yang kelas asas tu kan. Then my dad told me, "Hafiz, did you go to the revision class setiap minggu tu?" I don't, why? You know what, you are missing a lot of stuff kan. Then bila my dad beritahu tu, then barulah saya masuk.
Nasib baik ayah pesan macam tu.
Sebab ayah pesan begitulah kan.
Sebab tidak banyak yang aku terlepas tu.
Banyak terlepas. Definitely, I think I miss a lot jugalah for the first 2-3 months macam tu kan. And then I thought, okay. Then barulah saya faham, oh okay, macam ni dia punya cara trading, how to apply and everything kan. Okay. Then, biasalah Cikgu Kamal tu, when I met him, he was late 40s, 49-50. Dia meninggal umur 51 tahun 2013 kan. So dan dia biasalah orang tua 50, my father a bit younger than him waktu tu. Dan dia lah biasa orang tua nampak orang muda, budak innocent je kan. Dia suka ajak lepak apa kan. Kita orang muda dengar aje tadah je kan.
Betul.
So then saya pun waktu tu I was doing nothing other than trading. So I will spend time with him. And then I become part of dia punya team, admin whatever. This 2013 macam tu lah. So 2011 saya belajar betul-betul, and then penghujung 2011 tu baru saya start balik live trading, then saya nampak hasil dia. Then 2012 sepanjang 2012 consistent, tak pernah MC. And then 2000 awal hujung 2012 tu Then Cikgu Kamal ni, one thing about him, he's a very dedicated teacher. If you ask anyone yang pernah join kelas Jago, kalau tanya Cikgu Kamal ni macam mana orangnya, memang he's a very dedicated teacher lah. So bila dia tidak mendapat student baru, like macam he has his aim, dia nak kalau boleh setiap bulan tu ada intake baru like 30 ke 15 students baru kan. So penghujung 2012 tu macam orang dah start kurang nak join kelas forex. Waktu okay. tu pun
mungkin ada, dah banyak kelas-kelas forex.
Dah banyak kan, dia ada isu fatwa halal haram whatever it is. Banyak garbage lah waktu itu. And then waktu tu pun forex market is being so tainted with all those scams, with all those
banyak gila.
With all those apa dimomokkan dengan masuk $10 boleh untung 100 satu hari. Macam itulah those kind of negative.
Tahun tu lah
2012, 2013 gitu kan. So cikgu was asking for my favor, Hafiz, I need your help. Why don't because orang nak tengok statement cikgu dah tak percaya sangat kan. Contohlah kan. So cikgu was asking me, Hafiz, why don't you set aside some fund, kita buka satu account in a different broker yang waktu tu nak bekerjasama dengan Jago. Then kita tunjukkan account ni live in front of students. Yalah, biasa kan orang nak tengok live statement, whatever it is.
Bukti yang pure lah.
Pure lah kan. Nak tengok cikgu punya statement, orang dah kurang percaya. Nak tengok macam mana student dia pula berjaya kan, trading kan. Waktu tu cikgu Kamal punya style satu je. Biasa kalau student-student yang dah pergi kelas dia, kalau you dah pandai trade, you diam, you silent, diam saja. I mean, cikgu punya style was that. Okay, kalau dah you dah trade dah okay, kalau you janganlah expose sangat di FB kan. Kalau you tak ada nak jadi IB ke, nak jadi pengajar ke,
diam-diam
silent saja. So bila dia minta tolong student-student yang silent tu, dia orang tak nak expose. Kan. So saya pula kebetulan rapat dengan dia, and then I was like, kita orang muda, kita follow lah orang tua cakap apa kan.
Okay.
Bekat cikgu lah waktu tu kan. So I was like, okay cikgu. Then saya terfikir pun, cikgu Kamal pun dah banyak tolong saya dalam saya punya trading. Then I was like, okay cikgu, kita start bulan 2. Sebab from my experience punya trading, bulan 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 tu is the best time to trade. Kan? Baru lepas awal tahun.
Jangan
kan?
Awal, jangan hujung.
Jangan hujung kan, dekat Christmas tu kan. So then put aside $2,000. Okay. Tu yang daripada $2,000 tu, sampailah dia meninggal in August 2013 tu, from 2000 is grow to 95,000. So and then waktu tu 95,000, almost 100,000 lah. So waktu tu dalam 2013 tu juga, if people ask me, Hafiz, is you punya trading style is active scalping? Tidak, is a very relaxed trading style. The lowest time frame yang saya tengok pun H1, H4 weekly. And then kebetulan tu juga waktu 2013 itu, Jago banyak pergi tour, pergi Kelantan, pergi Penang, jual-jual kelas lah kan. Kita buat preview kelas kan. So I was also at the same time travelling. So tengok chart pun jeling-jeling sikit kan. So then orang pun argue juga kan, you Hafiz rapat dengan Cikgu Kamal, boleh lah kan, mungkin Cikgu Kamal ada bagi insight.
Okay.
Tapi tidak, Cikgu Kamal is a very, I would say, very professional punya teacher. Even though orang yang selalu lepak dengan dia pun, bila dia tanya cikgu, ini nak trade ni boleh ke tak, apa signal ke, dia takkan bagi. You nak tahu lebih, you masuk dalam kelas revision ni tiap-tiap minggu kan. So
okay, baru kita dapat tahu kan.
Baru dapat tahu lah. So kita pun walaupun has a special relationship with Cikgu Kamal, kita kena masuk kelas juga kan.
Betul.
Because you know lah, it's need to be fair lah kan. Kalau kita orang lepak dengan Cikgu Kamal pun, dia lebih banyak cerita mengenai dia punya kehidupan prior to that, how dia become a successful trader, everything. Betul. Lah cerita. Orang tua suka cerita dia punya pengalaman.
Memang so, orang tua memang macam tu.
Kita orang muda memang suka dengar lah kan. Boleh ambil banyak pengajaran kan. So so it become successful lah waktu tu. Saya pun tak percaya I could go from 2000 kepada almost 100,000 in 6 months. And then baru tu lah saya boleh faham macam mana Aunty Mona juga can go from 1000 to 100,000 US dalam masa 3 bulan. So itulah.
Maknanya rentak tu, catchy tu dah dapat.
Yes. And then kalau Pak Su ingat pun, 2013, it is one of the best time to trade in my opinion. I don't think we can find trading situation macam 2013.
Ha,
sebab waktu itu kalau saya trade, kalau saya analisa GU and EU, kita boleh like pejam sebelah mata jeling, we can buy. Katakan kita nak buy GU EU, kita boleh apa, pejam sebelah mata, we can buy EJ, we can buy GJ. At the same time kan, dia punya pair tu seiringan, yeah, lah kan. Seiringan. So just unless satu pair you can masuk ni. So my account is growing, it's a bit easy lah waktu tu kan. It's a bit easy tapi memudahkanlah trading waktu itu. Tak macam sekarang, kadang-kadang dia punya correlation berbeza kan, cuma bersikit lah kan.
Okay, sangat menarik. Okay, kemudian kita dah tahu tentang pahit dan kemanisan. Bagi Hafiz nak lahirkan macam mana kemanisan yang pernah dikecapi?
Okay, as a trader, that was my best performance 2000 to 95,000 in 6 months. And then
selepas daripada itu,
now my satisfaction lebih kepada when I look at my students yang ada good performance. Because I still remember when I was losing on oil tu. Waktu tu nak dekat puasa, nak dekat raya.
Okay.
So bila saya cut loss, I lost 25,000. Daripada 25,000, it went down to 70,000 US dollar waktu itu. Then I waktu WhatsApp Cik Kamal lah, "Cikgu, I really need your help on to lift me up lah untuk naikkan semangat saya in trading and whatever it is kan." So Cik Kamal cakap, "Hafiz, okay, lepas raya kita jumpa." Tapi tak sempat because dia meninggal dalam raya kedua, ketiga, dalam satu minggu yang pertama tu lah. Yelah, Cikgu Kamal pun waktu kita pergi tour and everything, dia ada beritahu lah, "Hafiz, if one day saya tak ada, then maybe kalau boleh I want you to continue my legacy untuk teruskan mengajar kan." Sebab dalam 2013 pun waktu Cikgu Kamal buat kelas pun, saya sudah didedahkan lah dengan student-student jago. Saya pun dah start ajar simple-simple topik kan waktu tu kan. So then selepas saya take over jago tu as a main punya training provider, yelah, kita daripada seorang trader to become a teacher, it needs some transitional period.
Memang,
apa tu,
dia perlu,
perubahan kan. Dia perlukan transitional punya period tu lah kan. So I was really struggling in teaching. And then Cikgu Kamal dulu dia bagi tahu satu je, "Hafiz, not just me lah, to all student jago kan, kita dalam dunia ni boleh jadi jago dalam satu bidang saja. So let's say in a forex punya industry, if you really want to become a good trader, you just focus on that. If you want to become a really good teacher, you focus on that." So nak jadi jago dalam dua-dua bidang tu pun agak mustahil. Even for him, bila dia start decide untuk mengajar tu pun, account dia pun dia tak usik sangat, just trade sikit-sikit, dia tak trade actively. Because
dia lebih kepada, dia tumpukan kepada
macam habis itu, itu memang dia punya aim untuk melahirkan 100 jutawan waktu itu. So for myself, yalah, it's a psychological punya change. And then I was really struggling jugalah dalam first few years dalam saya mengajar tu, hujung 2013, 2014, then 14 saya get married. 14 saya get married, I think. 14, 15. And then 14, 15, 16 tu lah. Kalau Pak Suprasan, jaguh punya zaman kegemilangan daripada 2010, 11, 12, 13. Dia meninggal. Kalau perasan jago tiba-tiba macam diam. Very silent kan. That was partly from my side yang saya tak dapat fine tune lagi saya punya teaching. Yalah, kita at the same pun kita nak trade. Lepas tu bila kita punya performance tak berapa better tu, then I just silent lah. And then waktu tu pun baru kahwin. Then sama juga psychological as a trader, waktu you bujang and waktu you kahwin pun different juga kan. You get what I mean?
Sangat
berbeza kan. When we are single, we don't care lah kan, we don't have that added pressure, whatever it is. So then I stay back kejap, you know, jago pun apa, tenggelam hidup waktu itu. And then there's one time in 2017, I think early 2017, macam tu, there was a student from Brunei. Dia ada pergi tengok YouTube Cikgu Kamal waktu tu. So dia carilah jago ni mana ni kan. Nanti dia jumpa saya. Then dia cakap, "Ada buat kelas lagi tak?" Cakap, "Ada lah buat kelas kan, sikit-sikit kan." So dia bayar saya, tak mahal tu lah, 300 setengah, I don't remember exactly. So then I ajar dia. Dia masuk kelas saya tiap-tiap minggu. And then dia jadi student yang sangat berjaya waktu tu. So bila dia banyak share, dia experience, dia dah start making money, and that give me some kind of hope, some kind of semangat. Okay,
semangat tu datang balik.
Yeah, okay, maybe I should revive balik jago. Then alhamdulillah sejak 2018-19 for the last 2-3 tahun, pertengahan 2017 tu sampai ke sekarang, almost setiap minggu saya ada buat kelas revision online. So daripada seorang punya daripada student ni, dah daripada satu adalah dalam 20 orang yang sudah boleh train consistently. So that is really a good satisfaction to me lah.
Pencapaian kan? Yeah, rasa pencapaian. Kepuasan sebagai seorang coaching. Yes, ya Allah. Exactly. Baik, kita dah sembang panjang. Nanti 5 minit terakhir nanti saya beri peluang untuk promote kelas bila-bila atau macam mana nak berjumpa, nak pergi ke Jago. Okey, sebelum tu.
Apa dah yang dah aku 10 eh. Tak ada break dah.
Ha, itulah tu. Apa yang perlu ada kepada seorang trader? Kita ambil yang baru lah.
Okay. Alright. To me, in my opinion, untuk menjadi seorang trader yang berjaya, you can come from any background. It doesn't matter.
Betul.
Yang penting, you must have a very good discipline. Because, as I said, I have three mentors yang beri influence kepada saya. Cikgu Kamal, Aunty Mona and Chris Lowry. Okay, Chris Lowry background dia daripada Olympian, a very successful Olympian, nak jadi sportsman yang berjaya mesti ada disiplin tinggi.
Betul.
Cikgu Kamal pula dia bukannya apa biasa-biasa. Sebelum dia join in a business world, trading punya world, he was in special force in Malaysia ni lah, in one of the branches kan. He was a special force in dalam kita punya unit uniform ni. Then lepas tu dia keluar, dia retire daripada special force, then he become a trader. And dia juga seorang businessman yang berjaya.
Tentulah dia disiplin. Ha.
Kalau you nak jadi special force, the unit uniform kan yang biasa-biasa. Special force, yeah, unit khas kan.
Unit khas.
So that really is a you must have a very good discipline lah, satu. And my student from Brunei tu pun, he was in dalam army kat sana. So very successful untuk jadi trader yang berjaya. In my opinion, you can come from any background, tetapi you must have a strong discipline. Itu satu. And then to me, in my opinion, the simpler the better. I mean, kalau kat chart tu tak perlulah terlalu banyak apa indicator atau kind of stuff. Okay.
Baik.
Lain, money management is very important, and you must have a mindset as a trader. Okay, Cikgu Kamal, walaupun dia seorang trader, dia juga adalah seorang businessman yang berjaya juga. Okay. Kita ingat trader ni macam like every day you monitor market. It's like
biasanya
macam itulah kan. Maksud saya dalam masa satu hari tu, kalau nak monitor market 10 jam ke 5-6 jam contohlah kan.
Okay.
Kalau setiap saat nak tengok chat kan, bini suruh pergi pasar pun tak pergi, contohlah kan.
Oh, berat tu.
So maksud juga Kamal, dia beritahu saya, seorang trader yang berjaya dia hanya bekerja pada hari Minggu. Sebab hari Minggu ni market tutup, this is when you analisa punya pasaran. Dan bila analisa tu, you dah mark all those level that you
semua
want.
Dah mapping siap.
Dah mapping siap kan. So pada hari Isnin, Selasa, Rabu, Khamis, Jumaat, you just take action saja. So kalau lah pada hari weekdays tu baru you nak analisa, bila market dah bergerak baru you nak analisa kan, dah kelang kabut, dah agak perang sikit kan.
Maksudnya so, persediaan awal. Kita persediaan buat mapping awal, yeah, supaya market jalan je kita tahu dah.
Yes, so okay. That's why at the same time the business and another dia macam ni.
Lain
disiplin.
Disiplin, simple.
Yang bagus. Kalau orang tanya saya sangat tak suka kalau orang satu pair tu dia trade berlapis-lapis. I don't like it.
Berlapis-lapis.
It's not that I condemn that one, tapi it's just that saya tidak diajar macam tu. Daripada you masuk berlapis-lapis satu ni, baik you rangkumkan semua jadi satu kan. Contohnya you berlapis-lapis 0.1, 0.1, 0.1, 0.1, baik 100.0 ke ataupun 10.0 tu pun contoh
sekali
lah kan.
Okay.
Because I tried that dulu yang berlapis-lapis, tapi nak waktu tu zaman manual kan, nak close sesuatu tu macam gabra kan. Sekarang mungkin senang dah ada auto ke apa tu kan. So money management, discipline, and the simpler the better. And take your time in trading. Jangan terlalu gopoh, itu saja. I always believe that there is always opportunity in trading. It's just that when that right opportunity tu datang, duit you ada. Bukan tentu you dah MC. Contohlah hari ni kan market was moving like GA, GN, okay. Get up and then move up by 1,000 pips and then turun balik ke bawah apa semua kan. So I hope tak ada siapa MC waktu tu. Because after that, dia naik betul turun balik kan. So okay. So untuk mengelakkan UMC, you must have a good money management kan. Itulah satu.
Kena pandai, kena bijak jaga duit.
Itu
duit bukan senang nak cari kan.
Betul, exactly. Especially zaman sekarang.
Zaman sekarang ni. Okay, kepada penonton-penonton di luar sana, orang lama, newbie ataupun orang yang baru nak berkecimpung, yang nak bersama dengan Hafiz
Jago. Okay. Boleh.
Sebelum tu, Jago sekarang ni under Hafiz bersama dengan tim atau macam mana?
Ya, lupa nak mention about that. Jago right now is being conducted by me and also by Coach Helmi. Okay. So student lama dia kenal Coach Helmi Afandi ni. Siapa Helmi Afandi ni? Dulu dia orang yang sama-sama bila Jago lah dengan arwah cikgu waktu awal-awal. So Jago ni we have two trading coach. Saya dengan Helmi. Yang macam saya lebih kepada swing trading. Kalau saya tengok pun lebih kepada weekly, daily, H4. Paling lower saya go pun H1. So what happened to Helmi is that saya invite dia masuk dalam, ajak dia untuk sama-sama in Jago, was that waktu tu saya ada terima banyak student yang background dia trade Galaxy Index stock, local shares. And I don't trade local shares, saya tak pernah trade local shares, so saya nak ajar, so tak berapa kena lah kan. So Helmi pula dia involved in local stock market. So dia ajar,
jadi ada dua,
lah. Tapi now dia pun dah tak berajar sangat local stock market, sebab Helmi punya specialize sekarang ni is that if you want to look in entry yang lebih accurate, whether in 5 minute or H1, kita ada dedicated teacher. So right now Jago ni tengah popular dengan scalping punya method. So we have a really very good students yang percaya in scalping punya background. So to be honest, if you go to Jago, if you join as a Jago member, you have trading style yang long term, mid term, ada yang short term in terms of scalping. Kita juga cover local stock market, kita juga cover forex, we have some major indexes, index macam saya, I personally trade Nasdaq, I personally trade Dow Jones. And dalam Helmi punya group pula kita ada analisa on some US punya shares, those kind of stuff lah.
Padat kelas ni. Okay, nak menghubungi.
Okay, if you want to contact Jago, kita ada FB Jago Technical Analysis, and ada
Jago?
Jago Technical Analysis.
Technical Analysis.
And we also have FB page Jago Academy.
Jago Academy. Ni FB page
FB Jago Technical Analysis. I have my own personal FB, tapi I tak expose sangat.
Okay.
So kita juga pada hari apa ni? Pada hari Sabtu ni. Okay. We will have a class. Okay. Kita ada kelas satu hari di KL, somewhere in TTDI. Okay, so what we do in that class satu hari tu, session pagi tu saya akan saya akan ajar session pagi. Lepas tu lepas lunch tu Cikgu Helmi akan ajar pula. Okay, it's free class. Okay, you can join that class. Okay, and then from that, if you want to continue di bawah Jago punya mentorship, you can decide. Okay, for that class, you can contact saya punya admin. You can call him at
012-399-2523.
So tu nama dia Ryan lah. So dia Jago punya one of admin. So if you wanna, if you have time to come pada hari Sabtu ni, sorry bukan Sabtu, Ahad 15 March.
Ahad, okay.
You can come and contact admin. So I punya Telegram is dia punya Twitter handle tu Hafiz the Trader. HAFIZ THETRADER. Okay, so you can contact me nak tanya pasal kelas, tapi better go to admin lah. So
senang admin nak urus. Okay, ribuan terima kasih. Saya nak ucapkan tahniah juga, dan saya doakan semoga Coach Hafiz akan terus memberikan khidmat, membantu trader di luar sana yang amat-amat memerlukan ilmu, pengalaman Hafiz. Sekarang ni Hafiz dah berjaya, alhamdulillah.
Bolehlah, alhamdulillah.
Alhamdulillah. Dan banyak pengalaman yang ni kurang ni, sepatutnya kalau nak jumpa sendiri dekat kelas boleh tanya apa saja. Okey, tuan-tuan dan puan-puan, masa pun dah mencemburui kita.
Pukul 10 Pak Su.
Dah. Okey, baik, kepada semua terima kasih yang telah pun memberikan perhatian anda. Wow, penonton